My name is Jalila Salman. I work as school assistant to principal in Ministry of Education, and I am vice president of Bahrain Teachers Society, and I live in Manama. I have small family, me and my husband and three kids. The youngest is 6 years old and the oldest is 11 years. And as you see, they are just kids and they saw what they saw. So till now, they are very terrified from anything that happens. Even if a small noise they hear at the house, they just will jump and feel, oh, mama, what's that? In anything, any event, if I want to go out, or even if I want just to go to the supermarket, they will be afraid. Mama, are you sure you are coming back? So, yes, yes, my kids. I will be back. I hope so. We are the only society in Bahrain who bring raises in salaries for teachers 3 times in just 2 years. And that was, I think this, we were under focus for that, because as you know, we are just a few members according to all other societies. Although we are more than 1,000 teachers in the society, but not all of them are working inside. There are just a few who are working, maybe 30 or 40. And these 30 people or 40 people, they take it seriously to raise up the teacher competencies in all directions. This is what I believe.
So people outside have an idea. What is the average salary of a teacher in Bahrain?
Around 400 dinars.
Per month?
Per month. I would say this is for the starting, because as you go on, you will get the raise in salaries. And this was not before. This is after the raises, and what we ask for, it comes to this. BTA is just part of the whole overall community here in Bahrain. So BTA will not be a part of that. When the trade union announced the strike, we have to be part of that. And not just because they announced it, but because also, you know, it was 14th of February, and that day, the Thursday 17th, there it was in mid-semester vacation. We call it here in Bahrain spring holiday. So a lot of teachers were there, not as teachers, as normal citizens. And a lot of them were affected there. Some of them were sleeping there that night and they saw what they have saw. Some of them have brothers injured. So they just came to us shouting, what are you going to do for us? We are your members. We are so and so. So what do you have to do? We were thinking, we don't have to work politics, but as a social thing, it's okay. So we go for that strike, and we were surprised, as I told you before, that from the second day of strike, Minister of Education announced that he wants volunteers in Minister of Education. And can you imagine which kind of volunteers were there? Most of them were under secondary. They don't have even secondary certificate. Me, myself, as a school principal, I saw these papers in my school, and my principal, he just took them away from me. He didn't let me anymore to see them because I saw what I have saw. And I told her, she's just intermediate. How she can teach in the class? Intermediate student? She needs who teach her, who make her to understand what she's going to teach. But the thing was going on, and teachers were badly attacked inside the school, mostly psychological, at the beginning, mostly psychological. From the principal, from their colleagues who were there in schools. Actually, I didn't see much inside the schools. I heard much because I was from the beginners who were actually maybe the first one in school who were arrested. It was me. So I just hear the things from the teachers who were arrested after me, and they came to the detention center. They were telling me stories. Come on. There should be something. I don't know. Everybody went mad. about the things we were telling. Buses were going to schools, taking students and teachers, principals to the interrogation centers, to the Ministry of Interiors. The teachers are beating. There is cases that students have been told to beat their teachers in front of everybody. Teachers have been, and when they put them all in the bus, there is no places, for example, they will force the teachers to sit on the students and will start beating them. Of course, leave the humiliation, the insulting, the verbal insulting, this will be all there. It is all, it's all registers and all reports are there. So, what can I say for that? Even the young students, the small students, were involved. It's not we involved them. It's just because they saw what happens to their families. If me, myself, I was a kid and I would see my father is being injured or killed, what do you expect from me? What do you expect from me? They didn't let even the student to cry inside the school. Most of the principals that they have, the schools were chaos there, I don't know, upside down their schools. It was because of their bad management. They opened the school doors for the students and let them to go outside to march or to do anything. And when these students come back to school, they will close the doors. They don't allow students to come in. They tell them, you want to participate, so go to the Lula roundabout. Come on. These are kids. In all three divisions that we have, primary, intermediate, and secondary, the biggest one will be, the oldest, will be 17 years. So they are teenagers, they are kids. And you are responsible for their life. How can you do this? I don't know how I can do this. My children are badly affected, badly. I told you from the beginning, now I think they need a psychotherapy, even though my husband is a psychologist, but he can't do anything for them. They are afraid, afraid will be just a little word according to what they are living in. Even when I go, see now, you saw my telephone. This is what my daughter was calling me. Each of them, I know when I answer her, she will just ask me, Mom, are you sure you are coming back? This is the only word they told me. They don't want me to leave the home. They don't want anything. They just will sit around me. I don't know. My kids are really badly affected. By the way, one of my kids have hemangioma in her leg. And I have to do an operation for her. And I did this operation twice here in Bahrain, but it was not successful. So they gave me to do this operation outside Bahrain, but I am banned from travel. And try to remove that ban. Till now, it's impossible for them. Even though I told them, even if you are going to put a personal guard for me, it's okay, because my intention is to do the operation for my daughter, not anything else. I'm not running away. I'm not running away. I'm not leaving my country because I didn't do anything. I didn't do anything, not me, nor anyone of my colleagues. We were just telling others, this is our opinion. This is what we think. And all the statements which we released were, I think most of the world have seen them and translate them and see what's going on them. And most of the human rights organizations are saying it's just an opinion. That's it, it's just an opinion. And most of the statements were just a reflection of what's going on, because the officials in the Ministry of Education refuse to listen. They just want their own voice. So we have to talk to them. And at the beginning, maybe two or three statements, I make sure myself that it's delivered to facts to Minister of Education. So I'm sure he received it because we fax it to before it comes to any other people. So we are not doing anything wrong. Even now, I'm telling you, if it goes back, I don't think we will do something other than what we did. I thought that we are protected because the international law is saying that any an organization members should be under a cover for them. We should be safe by law. But there is no law. For that, we are not safe. If there is a law, and law will be on the ground, we will see it, we should be safe. Not just safe. Everything we should be canceled. There is nothing of this should be happening. But it's still going on in schools, still. Just yesterday, 3 schools, 30 teachers are dismissed for 10 days. This is continuous, it's going on. There is a lot of salary cut, or even the salary stopped. For me, myself, is one case. I didn't receive a salary since February, even before I was arrested. I was arrested 29th of March. So by that way, even my salary in March should be, I should get it, but I didn't. So I think there was an intention to do something with us. From that day when we didn't receive the salary, we thought, oh, they are thinking about us. But we didn't know, you know, if you believe that you didn't do anything wrong, that's what. We believe that we didn't do anything wrong. The Crown Prince himself came on TV and he said, you have the right to protest. Only then, the Crown Prince was there on Saturday. And we were shown on the Pier Landaud on Sunday. That means after his word. He gave us the right, and then they are punishing us that we listen to them. Yani, it's our mistake now that we listened to them and we believed them. This is the mistake. We shouldn't believe in them. Maybe that was better. At least he didn't come out and he didn't tell all these people, okay, go to the roundabout. Do what you want to do peacefully. What's next? Mahdi Abu Dhib is sentenced, that's the PTA head, for 10 years. And he is still in prison. He's not just in prison, he is facing a lot of torturing till now. Me, myself, twice arrested. And in both of times, it was terrible raiding to my house in front of my kids and all my family. And what I get from that? Nothing. ها ماما نعم ماما زين حبيبي كملي دراسات شو لا تخافون برجع لكم أنا أوكي أوكي ماما بس بالعدالة ها إنزين أي بعد بجي شوي أوكي يلا باي باي